I'm gonna teach you guys how to draw a monkey. So before we begin, make sure you grab yourself a sheet of paper, a hard surface. I'm using the folder full of my other drawings. You need an eraser, a pencil, perhaps a sharpener, maybe some extra supplies here. And also, if you want to be able to color in your monkey, you'll need some various coloring tools. In here, I have my colored pencils. I like to use these for the outlines, and I'll be demonstrating that later on in the video. And I also have the crayons, which I like to use for the bigger surface areas. So, you guys ready to draw a monkey? Let's begin. So, I always start with the head whenever I'm drawing something. So, for this monkey, I'm gonna draw a nice head. It's okay if your circle's not perfect. Go ahead and fix it, like mine has a little extra nub. I'm just going to erase that. Nothing wrong with having to erase. And then you just redraw it as smooth as you can, or if you don't care, then yeah, doesn't matter. So there's my head for the monkey. Nice big circle. Of course, it's not gonna stay a circle. We're going to edit it later. But this is for the basic outline. So now that we have the head, we're going to need like a little neck here. This monkey's gonna be sitting down. So we need at least a little bit of a neck. So what I would do is put some little lines here to denote where the neck is. And from there, we can draw the monkey's chest. Get yourself a nice arch right there. And then we're gonna draw the shoulder. Sorry if I'm going too fast, but usually these videos take forever. So I wanna make sure this is nice and quick. If you're not this fast, that's okay. Take your time. For the shoulder, I'm gonna draw another little semicircle thing here. At the base of the neck. So now we have a head, a neck, a shoulder, and a chest. And from the base of the shoulder blade, I'm gonna draw another big line around. That's the back of the monkey. Now, of course, there's gonna be some editing here as well. Don't draw it too small, but don't draw it too big, because you gotta have room on the paper. All right. From there, we can add the arm. We're gonna start like a few inches away from the shoulder blade. And put a line down to pass the shoulder. And then we're gonna draw another line a little ways away, following the same path. So this tube here, that's going to be the arm. Now an arm is going to need a hand. So draw some lines off of that. If you make a mistake, bring him to erase. Try again. All right. So now that we have the main lines of the hand, we can add the fingers. Not too human-like, but make sure you put the little fingers on. Make sure you put all fingers. 5 fingers. If you make a mistake and it looks awkward, erase, try again. Like, I'm going to redo that finger right there. On the end, the pinky finger looks a little off, so I'm gonna just redo it. And there it is. One monkey hand. And then you can draw another line from behind the chest to about the same area. We're going to draw the second arm. So just draw a short little line here. And then draw a few more fingers. The rest are out of sight. So now our monkey has two hands. Going to need to add a leg. So what I do for the leg is I'm going to draw a big C and close to the end of the backbone around. And then we're going to add the little feet. The leg extends here. Alright, from there, you can draw little toes. And then we're going to close up the gap, draw the belly of the monkey. Like that. Just draw a nice, very subtle arch. Or if you want to make your monkey skinnier, you can make it more upward, like a triangle or something. And now we're going to add the second foot. So, like we did for the hand, there's only going to be a few toes showing because the rest of it is hidden out of sight. So there's the feet of the monkey. We're almost done with the basic outline. Of course, we're also going to add a face to the monkey. But before that, we're going to add a tail. Now, your monkey can have pretty much any kind of tail you want. So a tiny little tail, a long tail, a medium length tail, I don't know. Depends on what kind of monkey you really want to draw. Now, it's not going to have a super long tail like my original character Lulu, but I'm going to put a nice tail on. So from the base of the base of the backbone, about where the hip starts, I'm going to draw a line. It's a tail. Now this is how long the tail on this monkey is going to be. But yours doesn't have to be that long. As long as the monkey has a tail, it's a monkey. Now we're going to loop it around like this, make a little curve. And just continue the line back to where it starts. Like that. Now your monkey has a tail. And now we're going back to the head. We're going to add ears. So what I like to do is take some semicircles, place them at the sides of the head. Here's the first one. I'm gonna make a second semicircle. since the outline of the ears. And then you're gonna add other semicircles to inside of those to continue the ears. Use the first one. And then you just do the same to the other side. And now your monkey has complete ears. Now, for the face, you can make the face shaped like anything. Pretty much can be an oval, a circle, a heart. Lulu has a heart-shaped face. For this one, I'm going to do kind of like a rounded triangle. So I'm going to start a few inches away from each ear. Like this. I'm going to wrap it around the cheek area. And then repeat for the second side. Now you have the outline of the face. Now, within that space that you have, you can give your monkey a nose, a mouth, and some eyes. So we're gonna go do that. We're gonna start with a little nose. I give this one almost semicircle oval nose, little tiny nose. You can add whatever kind of nose you want to your monkey. It is your monkey after all. And I'm gonna put some eyes. You can make a circle or almond or whatever. I'm gonna do circles for this one. Put a circle on both sides. And then we're gonna continue from there. More circles within the big circles. So now you have eye white and iris. Now you're gonna have the pupil in the middle. And if you want, you can add like a little shine spot inside the pupils. Give your character some more light and personality. And since the eyes are kind of a thin area, I'm going to, of course, color them in the colored pencils rather than the crayons. But if you want to use crayons, go ahead. If you want to use markers even, go ahead, do that. Do what you want. Now, from the nose, I'm going to start making the mouth. So I'm going to put a line directly from the middle of the nose. And we're going to curve it up to make it smile a little bit, but not too much. So it looks like anchor. Because if a monkey is grinning, that means it's about to attack you. So we're going to make this monkey more friendly, just a subtle little smile. Gentle, friendly little guy. Okay. Now that that's done, we can add extra details. I'm going to make my monkey's head fluffy. This is optional. So I'm just going to add a little bit of fluff to all the edges, so just lightly erase it, but not too much, so you can still see where the outlines were. Like that. And continue adding whatever you want, if you want. loud, that noise is in the background. It's the aquarium. There's Ryan. My monkey now has a fluffy head. And the rest of the body's gonna need details too, because otherwise he's gonna have a fluffy head, but then a smooth, weird, empty looking body. So I'm going to add a little bit of fluff to the shoulder. And I'm going to add a squiggle between the arm and the hand for the coloration changes. Like that. Fluffy chest. So I'm going to erase the chest and redraw it. Like a little line here for more coloration markings. I have a different color block on the chest. I'm going to erase the back and make the back fluffy as well. Super fluffy monkey. Snoopy's scratching a scratcher pad over there. Don't mind him. If you're wondering how I do the fluff, I just move my pencil like this. Very tight movements. I'm going to continue to fluffify the monkey by fluffing up the arms. And it's windy outside, so of course trash cans and recycling bins are rolling down the street like they belong there. Anyways, I'm going to erase the stomach a little bit and redraw Fluffy as well. The monkey can have a fluffy belly. And what I did with the hands, I'm going to continue with the feet. So the feet can have different colors, just like the hands do, and then the rest of the body. Different kinds of monkeys have different coloration patterns, so feel free to do what you like there. Going to make the legs fluffy. Erasing again. And for the rest of the fluff, we're going to make the tail fluffy. You might be wondering, why draw the outlines if you're just going to erase them? Well, it helps give you a little guide of where everything goes. Because when you erase it just slightly, you can still see where it was. And that will tell you where to put the new details. Can't do that on MS Paint. If you erase on MS Paint, the line is completely gone. So that's why I kind of have an easier time drawing on paper. And you guys are like, then why don't you use PaintShop Pro? Well, because I don't want to. I don't care if I'm being too basic and boring. This is how I want to do things. So fluffy monkey, right? Fluffy monkey. I think that Fluffy Monkey is ready to have some outlines colored in. So next, I'm gonna switch to the colored pencils and put the regular pencil away. Now, for this monkey, I'm going to do a simple coloration of brown, peach. I'm gonna need a little bit of black. And maybe a little bit of tan for the chest fluff. You can make your monkey whatever color you want, so don't worry. When I'm coloring, I like to start with the lightest color first. So I'm going to dig out my peach colored pencil. And if it's looking, if your colored pencils are looking a little dull, just sharpen up. Ready to go. And then just trace the outline of the colored pencil. If you're not this far, don't worry, take your time. Better to take your time to get a good product than to hurry up and end up with trash. So, I'm not saying your work's gonna be trash. Go ahead, do what you want. I'm sure your art looks good. So, now, I'm going to outline the face. I'm not sure if that's gonna pick up on camera, but I used peach there. Apricot is also a similar color that can work if you're trying to do the same colors as I am. Apricot works just as well as peach. So they did outline of the hand. And the other hand, which is mostly hidden, so we're only going to cut a little bit. I don't see that, I see the hand there. Because of the angled sap. And the feet. Now, what I like to think is that the face, ears, hands, feet are covered in a light covering of super soft peach colored hair. So here's how the monkey's looking so far. And next up, we're going to brown. And no, tan. Tan is lighter than brown. I'm going to put the tan on the chest. That. And then to brown. I have so many colored pencils in this one box. Now, this isn't even all my colored pencils, guys. I have a special set that I use only for very special occasions. So, there's that as well. You know the video Blazing Timber? Yeah, I used my super secret stash of colored pencils on that one. And I'm working on Achilles still, using those colored pencils. And those colored pencils are important. Those are a birthday present of mine. Last year. From a very good friend of mine. That's why I only like to use them for special purposes. Anyhow, back to the picture, now that I've found my brown colored pencil. I'm outlining the ear, the outer ear. And the other outer ear. And then I'm gonna show you it. Show you how much I've done. Alright. Also guys, if you have a particular animal you want to see me draw, or maybe not an animal, I'm not really good at drawing characters, but just like humans, animals, objects in general, let me know in the comments what you want to see, because that will tell me what to draw next. Now, the monkey was suggested to me. I really appreciate that. Because otherwise I start doing repeats, like how I repeated the cat and I repeated the wolf, but they were improved versions in my opinion. I know you guys didn't really like my how to draw a dog video for some reason. Hardly anyone even watched that one. Oh well. If you don't want to do outlines, you don't have to, by the way. I forgot to mention that the outlines are also optional. Sorry if you were doing outlines this whole time thinking it was important. I'm going to color in the irises. Shoulder blade. I hope I'm not making this sound too complicated, because actually this is rather easy. Still working on brown, as you can see. It's gonna take a little while. Like that. And then the arm. And the other arm as well. Also brown. Lots and lots of brown. I think that brown is one of my most used colors. I have a few that I use a lot. Brown, black, red, and blue sometimes, I think. Also, I use dandelion a lot, but good thing I have a lot of extras now. Because they don't make dandelion crayons anymore. So if you guys want to use dandelion, well, sorry. Unless you already have one, so. I now have a blue-tiful crayon, but I have no use for it right now. I have plenty of blues already. What I really need was, and I luckily have, is those dark luscious golden. I'm pretty lucky to have a good sized collection of them. So I have finished the brown outline. Now just to do a little bit of black. for the pupils, and the nose are going to be black. Unless you guys like want to make your pupils a different color than black, but pupils are typically black. And so the cute little monkey has had its outline complete. If you're still working on an outline, don't worry, take your time. But I am about to move on to the final step, the main coloration. So I bust out those crayons. And as usual, start the lightest to darkest. So I'm going to use some peach. Apricot. Here's my peach. But like I said, apricot works just as well as peach. So if you want to use apricot, go ahead. Use whatever colors you want. Colored in the ears. Colored in the face. Using small strokes helps to stay where you want to go, but you know, if you cross the line, it's fine. Everyone makes mistakes. I definitely do it a lot, and I just did this eyeball. The eyeball now has a little bit of peach in it, but whatever. Hang on, guys. Alright, guys, I'm back. Also, I just realized this whole time I was not even wearing the hat I was gonna wear in the video. It's not relevant to the video at all, but I was gonna wear it. My Pokemon cap? Yeah. I completely forgot about that. But also, I had a phone call I needed to take, so that was important. Anyways, let's color in the hands. Well, for you guys, it wouldn't have been any time at all because I shut the camera off, so you guys wouldn't have known the difference. All right, so we color in the hands. Now we're gonna color in the feet. And now that the hands and feet and stuff are colored in, I can color in the chest. Here's some tan. And sometimes I just color it caramel. Like, especially if I'm referring to my character Frasier, I call his hair caramel. Well, also his dad, Ronald. Ronald Orkinstreya. If you guys haven't read my books, I highly suggest you go check them out before they're removed, because now that I'm getting in the groove of editing them for publishing, I might have to start removing some of the public versions. I already removed Legend of the Wolf Girl like 2 or 3 years ago, but that one will be coming out hopefully soon. Yeah, so just look for Violet, of course, on Inkit. Capital V, capital O, capital C, no spaces. I'll let you know in the description how to find me. If I remember. I'm kind of forgetful. But anyways, we're gonna finish coloring the monkey with brown. That is if you're following the same exact coloration. If not, then color in with whatever color you want to color in. So, here we go. So So I know there's a lot of how to draw videos on YouTube. So I have a lot of competition to work with. Though a lot of the how to draws are for kids specifically. This one? It doesn't matter how old you are, go ahead, draw. Drawing is not just for kids. Drawing is for anyone. And I very much enjoy drawing a picture every once in a while, even though I am an adult.
Oh no, adults don't draw pictures. They do actual artwork, because drawing pictures is not art.
And I say, whatever. There's a lot of art that goes into drawing actual pictures here. See? Like, look at that. If that's not art, I don't know what art is. I'm coloring in the arm. And the other arm. And the neck. And the, before the chest area. And also guys, you don't have to use Crayola products, I just like to use them in these videos. Other brands work too. And hey, my special brand, my special ones aren't Crayola. And they're still super, super special. So. There you go. Also, I apologize for the soda can in the background. Please ignore that. I guess I should have moved that before starting the video. And no, I'm not sponsored. So, that's just in the background because that's what I was drinking, so.
Everything except for the tail is colored in. He's gonna have a white tail.
No, I'm also going to color in the tail. The tail is not gonna be left white. Though, if you wanted to have a monkey with a white tail, then go for it. Use your imagination. Anyhow, monkey is complete. If you want to name your monkey, go ahead and give it a name. I don't exactly have a name in mind for this one. If you're not done yet, don't worry. Keep on going. But if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Let me know what animal or kind of person, like, do you want to see a woman or a child or female child, male child, baby, vampire, werewolf, object, anything, as long as it's not a specific character, because I'm not really good at drawing specific characters. Just give me a general idea of what you want to see. Let me know in the comments. And if you haven't already, please subscribe. Bye.